Back in, we started the business in 1971 in San Francisco. And at that time, there was no paper making, hand paper making whatsoever in this country. But there was some interest in it. And my wife, Catherine, being a printmaker, she was aware that artists felt a need for handmade paper, particularly paper made, especially for print projects.
So I was printing limited edition lithographs in San Francisco in 1971. And that's when we started Twin Rocker, just in our basement.
We formally began on April Fool's Day, which was
yes
appropriate.
Appropriate for
we had no idea what we were getting into.
Yeah, there was no professional handmill in America at that time, and so we really had no teachers. There were a couple of historical books on papermaking, mostly written by a very famous historian named Dard Hunter, who was kind of the father of contemporary papermaking. And we read those books, and Howard, being a mechanical engineer, designed and built the necessary equipment. But we're still making this by hand, so we were forming paper the way it was made in Europe in the 1600s, basically.
Papermaking is an ancient process. It was invented, as far as we know. The first written information about it was in China, right about 0 AD. And it basically is a process of creating a pulp out of, for centuries, it was only from the fibers that make rope and cloth, like cotton. Flax and hemp. Wood is very recent. And the process is you make pulp, and then this device is the key to the whole thing. It's called a papermaking mold. The edge is formed by the deckel, and it's permeable. And as you dip it in the vat, water drains through, the pulp remains on the surface, and then through a fairly complicated series of other events, you find up with a sheet of paper. But the whole trick is dipping it, shaking it, getting a nice even sheet, and then there's two tricks. One is making the pulp, second is dipping it, and then the drying process.
And then you can see here that on this mold there's a watermark, and the watermark is a wire that's hand bent and then sewn on the surface of the mold. This is called a laid mold because it has wires that stretch along the surface. Now, all of this is handmade. The mold and the deckel are all handmade by a craftsman, and another craftsman has actually hand-formed this wire into a design. And this wire casts a thin place in the paper, so the pulp forms around that wire, and when you hold the finished paper up to the light, then you can see the watermark because the paper is actually thinner there. There's a wonderful display of watermarks as part of this exhibit. Howard and I are featured in a movie called The Mark of the Maker by Chicago filmmaker David McGowan. This documentary movie talks about our life as papermakers, and it shows how we make paper at Twin Rocker, and also talks about how paper is used. So a calligrapher, Janet Lawrence, actually does calligraphy on handmade paper. A watercolor painter, Jim Cantrell, paints a watercolor right on camera. And also we are making paper for a limited edition book that's being printed by a British letterpress printer, Michael Gullick, actually at Twin Rocker in Brookston. So he came over from England to print this book with and the two of us collaborated on it, and then he actually binds part of the book. So people in the movie, they get to see the process of paper making along with how paper is used, how our customers use it. We were delighted when David McGowan entered the Mark of the Maker in several film festivals and won awards, and that qualified him to be able to enter it in the Academy for to be eligible to be picked as a nominee for an Academy Award. And he never really thought that a Chicago filmmaker, that this would happen, but it did. And so The Mark of the Maker was actually nominated for an Academy Award, and all of us went to Hollywood. It was very fun.
The World of Paper exhibition continues through January 10th of 2010 at Central Library downtown.